that I can provide, but I would like to refer you to our original position of why we believe that graduate students are graduate students and not employees of the university.
I might just add before there's other questions, we haven't even had a chance to talk with legal counsel, and I'm a lawyer, I haven't had a chance to read the opinion, so I think any comments more than the president just made are really premature. That's going to be, frankly, a subject of the closed meeting that's starting as soon as we get there.
Chair Steelman, I know you made comments during the meeting about the low turnout of feedback for the university task force.
Yes.
How do you and also Mr. Choi intend to gather more feedback and encourage more participation in that?
Well, I had a great professor here at law school who said there's no such thing as teaching, only learning. And I think what he would mean by that is that we have gone out of our way through a lot of efforts to publicize this meeting, to publicize the ability to give feedback, to make it available online in advance and even now. And, you know, all you can do is give people an opportunity, and the decisions are going to be made. And I hope they give us more feedback, but I think there's been an ample opportunity for faculty feedback.
This past the forum of the open mic wasn't the only opportunity for faculty and staff to provide input. We've had a number of meetings with faculty members from throughout the campus that are part of the Inter-Campus Faculty Council, as well as the Inter-Campus Staff Advisory Council. So they've had opportunities to provide feedback because many of these individuals who serve on these two very important committees are elected by their campuses, by their fellow faculty, as well as fellow staff members. And we're going to continue that level of discussions with them. And through online mechanisms, they can also provide their input as well.
I know I'll make the president, Alex Flinch, but I am disappointed by the lack of feedback by faculty.
I think we've had a couple of folks join us on the phone.
Yes. Anybody on the phone would like to ask a question? All right. Anyone else?
If I could just clarify a point you made during your presentation.
Yes.
Did I understand you to say that enrollment has rebounded to the point where it was before the protests, and also that black enrollment has, African-American enrollment has hit a new high?
So what I mentioned was that the applications have rebounded to the levels that existed from the period of fall 2015 until the summer of 2016. Now, in terms of enrollment, we still have some room to grow, but we're gonna do that strategically. We're not gonna be in a position where we're gonna lower our standards. We need to maintain our standards. We need to make sure that our students are provided the opportunity to take classes that they need on a timely basis so they graduate. So at Mizzou, they are pretty close this year to hitting their ultimate goal of about 5,000 to 5,200 freshmen. But they're also going to be focusing on increasing the transfer students through many of the collaborative programs that they've developed. And also, and UMKC, they will need to focus on growing the first-time freshman enrollment and rely less on transfer students who come to the university. Missouri S&T, with their highly selective designation by the state board, will also continue to increase their quality metrics, but at Missouri S&T, they've hit their capacity in terms of number of faculty members that can offer courses and the space available. So they're not gonna see much of an enrollment growth at the undergraduate level.
Can I say it before too? I see all the graduate students here, and I appreciate you being here. And again, I am very serious that for students and people like you to make your voices known, I think it's very effective sitting there in those red t-shirts, but I appreciate the fact that you're doing it in this way. So I recognize you're here in this
room. And also, as Chairman Stephen stated, we are gonna have a discussion about this in closed session. So there's nothing additional that we can provide in terms of an explanation, but are there any statements that the graduate students would like to make? Yes, if I can ask you to use the mic and turn around for the cameras, please, and introduce yourself.
First off, I should say that I'm not a graduate student. I am Dr. Eric Scott. I am a graduate of this institution as a family. And I can say that over the past 3 years, the continual statement from the university, from the Board of Curators, has been that you wanted legal clarification on our right to organize. You have that. You have that in the decision. The decision is not in any way ambiguous about this. You are trying to bust our union. Thank you.
This is your opportunity. Alex?
Oh, sure.
Yeah, please. You can turn around.
Alex Howe. I've been involved for a number of years, I suppose, most recently president for the graduate student government. I think this is an astoundingly poor decision, deeply disappointed, and look forward to what comes next.
Could you clarify what the decision you're speaking of?
If they decide to appeal the, I guess it's called a ruling of the summary judgment that we just had come down yesterday, that's the decision I'm referring to. Alex Howe, HWE. All right.
One more. If you can stand and face the camera.
There are multiple cameras. Can
you introduce yourself again?
My name is Joseph Moore. I'm a PhD candidate here at the university. I'd just like to echo what Eric and Alex have already said, but also I want to point out the fact that both of you have just said that you, A, have not had time to even read the decision, nor have you had time to consult with counsel, but somehow you've been able to make the decision that it's a good idea to appeal this without having read or consulted with legal counsel.
Let me clarify. I have read the decision, okay. And I have spoken to counsel, and I am the person that shared with this group that we intend to appeal.
And we haven't had a board meeting on it yet.
Okay. Seems a bit.
So, may I ask you, where did you go for your undergraduate degree?
Gettysburg College.
Gettysburg College. Thank you. Yep. Thank you for coming to Mizzou. All right. With that, we're going to close this press meeting. We have to go into closed session to discuss some business. So thank you, graduate students, and thank you very much for being here.